few numbers coming in. BJP is speaking ahead.
BJP is in the lead.
This is big. Tripura BJP is moving ahead. It's basically on 31 leads there. CPM slipping back to under the 30 mark, which is a major, major development just in the last 15 minutes. It could still change. We had with us the main architect of the Bharatiya Janata Party in the Northeast telling us, Mr. Sarma, telling us, wait, it's not over. Tripura will be BJP's. Meghalaya there, 56 out of 59. The Congress stuck at 20. But look at the other numbers. The Congress stuck at 20. The others are creeping up and moving ahead. You have a situation where Congress might be out of the picture. Both the left and the Congress might be out of the picture.
Sambit Patra, put a bet. Is Tripura going to be the BJP's victory? Will you be able to unseat the CPIM? Because just a little while ago, GVL Narasimha Rao stuck his neck out and said it is about victory over the ideology of the left. Will you be able to make it in Tripura?
No, of course. See, we had no seats in 2013 in Tripura, and if I am right, we had only 1.5% of vote share in Tripura. From no seats to almost forming a government, and within a few minutes it will be quite clear. From only 1.5% to, I know, it will be more than 40% vote share in Tripura, of course, with the kind of seats that you are showing. This is a great feat as far as BJP is concerned. But let me tell you as to why BJP is going to win Tripura. If you had been to Tripura, if you have particularly gone to Dhanpur, the constituency of the present Chief Minister, yes, Mr. Manik Sarkar, you would realize astonishingly that since 1998, Mr. Manik Sarkar is an MLA in Dhanpur, but Dhanpur does not have a college. Dhanpur does not have a hospital. Women have to travel 1.6 to 2 kilometers every day to fetch water. You would be astonished if you want to have fresh tea in Tripura. Aapko chai peeni ho Tripura mein, to Tripura mein doodh nahi milta hai. Despite the fact that we have a good dairy, industry there, but they don't have packaged milk. They don't sell milk out there. You have jackfruit across Tripura, but you have fruits across Tripura, oranges, but you don't have a single fruit shop. You don't have a single fruit juice ki dukan. Why? Why such backwardness for all these years? And let me break this myth. The real Manik Sarkar versus the virtual Manik Sarkar. The real Manik Sarkar is a corrupt Manik Sarkar. The virtual Manik Sarkar.
Well, there are three issues here. There are three issues here. It's obvious that the Congress's huge corruption charge is not stuck on the Bharatiya Janata Party, which is a very, very big deal, because this election was conducted in the shadow of Nirav Modi, conducted in the shadow of the so-called Rafael scam. The Congress made huge political capital. It's just not sticking. It's just not sticking, Mr. Kedkar. It's not sticking. It's not sticking to Mr. Modi personally. He campaigned very, very energetically in the Northeast.
The BJP's come from. The BJP's come from zero to.
It was a major issue.
Not just corruption, because of a number of issues, including the money part of the BJP has. And I'm not getting to.
Come on.
EVMs are bad.
I'm getting into something else.
No, EVMs are bad.
I'm not getting into the morality of what the BJP does. The worrying factor for me as Congress's biggest supporter is these results, and I'm sticking my neck out, means at least there'll be two swearing-ins for the BJP. And if
that means that the BJP has now become a viable party of governance in the Northeast, which is a slap on the face of the Congress and the left. Mr. Sarvanan, I want to bring you in. The DMK today is in the Congress corner.
Yes.
I think you better change your point of view. Even in the South. Look at this. The Congress booted out. It's going to be reduced to three states and a UT. And you have a situation where the left is fizzling.
Rahul, I heard your the interesting conversation. You're talking about that the corruption tangle is not sticking to Mr. Modi. That's why they were having this seats in Tripura. That is a different matter. But what happened to the by-election results in Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, everywhere?
The 2G result came in the UPA favor. Obviously, Rahul Gandhi is not being able to capitalize.